Well, with a brand new school superintendent on the job for just 6 days, Dr. Aaron Engel's very first La Crosse school board meeting focused on two very big issues: how to reopen schools with COVID-19 still being a threat, and the future of school resource officers tonight.
And let's start with the future of SROs. It was decided to create a new four-person committee called the Fund 80 Ad Hoc Committee to gather information that answers the question if La Crosse schools are better with or without SROs. The program is 27 years old, but times have changed and there is more pressure to reform police forces. And one of those ways is to reduce their presence in schools. The new superintendent did not have a resource officer in his last position heading up the Galesville-Ettrick-Trempealeau School District, so he says he's been researching the pros and cons of their presence in schools.
There are issues where we naturally need to work together, whether it's enforcing, local ordinances such as truancy or smoking violations. And it's also important in terms of broader safety in our community for the law enforcement agencies to understand our buildings and be able to respond to emergencies in a timely and effective way. There's also data that indicates a correlation between school resource officers and suspensions, not causality, but a correlation between those issues. And one of the things that we want to ensure we disrupt as educators is the school to prison pipeline. And we know that when students are suspended out of school or incarcerated as a juvenile, it increases the likelihood that as adults they'll spend time in prison. And we consider that, very important to us as educators to disrupt that pathway.
The board is already getting feedback from those who support officers in schools and others who don't. Two of them shared their opposite views tonight.
If our schools are safer, it's because of the work done by social workers, counselors, mental health crisis providers, school nurses, crossing guards, and others. We want to see our community reinvest dollars currently allocated for SROs to employ people with the same level of education and knowledge as the rest of the school staff.
Anyone that insists the 21 schools don't need SROs after this year need to speak to the students and staff at Longfellow Middle School, because after we complete an active threat shooter in the school drill, each classroom I have been in for the past 5 years during that drill, the students overwhelmingly state to me and the teacher that they are glad the SRO is at the school protecting them.
The new four-person committee has a tight timeline of 3 weeks to gather information with an end date of July 27th. However, they are not expected to have a final decision by that time or even by the beginning of the school year. In all likelihood, SROs will be there on the first day of school until a decision is made, but their contract ends in June of next year.